In this video, we learn about the 5 mistakes, how to handle the mistakes, and better not to make the mistakes by doing the filing in Germany. My name is Holger Petersen, tax lawyer from Taxfba. You are a seller from Europe or non-European seller, and you have to be registered in Germany, and you have to give your monthly filing to the German tax authority. And of course, this filings have to be correct. However, there are often a lot of mistakes in this data we get from our customer, for our clients. And here I show you the 5 main mistakes the seller are doing while giving us the information, the necessary information for the tax authority in Germany. The first main mistake is that the sales on this list are not correct. Better is to use the MWS token from Amazon if you're a seller from Amazon. However, you also can have some other platforms, and we need the data, but the data have to be complete because the tax authority in Germany is able to check this data, and if they are not correct, they come and check and doing some audits, and the audits, with audits you may lose a lot of money. So it's better not to have an audit. So please take care that the sales are complete on this reports you give to the tax lawyer who's doing the filing for you. The second mistake is the start date from selling in Germany. You have to give the start date, the correct start date, when you used a warehouse first time in Germany, because also this can be checked by the tax authority. So for example, you started selling or using a German warehouse in Germany in 2017, and you applied for a tax number in 2019, and we give the monthly filings to the tax authority from January 2019. First of all, it seems to be fine, but the tax authority, they really check on your account on Amazon when was the first selling, and if the selling starts in 2017, of course we have to give also the filings or the annual declarations to the tax authority for the further times. So please always work with the right start date, because the tax authority in Germany is able to check it. The third mistake, incorrect invoices. I know that a lot of companies, they do not really care about their invoices. They sell B2C, the customer does not want to have the invoice, and so it's not that important for everyone. However, the German tax authority, in case of an audit, wants to see every invoice, or at least a list of the invoices. And the invoices have to be correct, have to be to show the correct VAT. So let's say if the sale has to be declared in Germany, 19% VAT and not 20% from Austria or 23% from Poland. So be aware of the right invoices. So your program also has to give out the right invoices. The next mistake, it is depends on the intra-community movement. What is an intra-community movement? Intra-community movement is if you use more warehouses in Germany in Europe, than just one in Germany. So especially if you're a seller on Amazon, Amazon uses and sends the goods from warehouse Germany to warehouse Spain, for example. And this movement is an intra-community movement. This intra-community movement does, it's free, tax-free, However, you have to declare. You have to declare in Germany and you have to declare in Spain, and the governments, Germany and Spain, they match. And if it doesn't match, there's a problem. Especially a problem could happen from the 1st of January 2020, because the law in Germany changes. Right now, the intercommunity movements are not really good declared, and the German tax authority is the opinion, okay, if you don't declare from the 1st of January 2020, if you don't declare, it might be that this movement is not tax-free anymore. So it's a really a big risk not to declare the movements. You have to declare, and the problem here is you have to declare with this, not with the selling price, but with your costs for the goods. So it's a little bit complicated to calculate the number, however you have to do it. And the fifth big mistake sellers are doing is in Europe we have thresholds between the countries. For example, if you send goods from the German warehouse to Austria, there's a threshold about 35,000 euro. We talk about B2C business. And if the deliveries to Austria are more than 35,000, it changes like this. You don't have to write German invoices anymore if you pass the threshold, but you have to write Austrian and invoices, and of course your declaration has not to be anymore in Germany but in Austria, or in Germany and Austria as well. So this date we have to calculate exactly, and we have to handle it right. If you want to avoid these mistakes, please contact my VAT team. We know exactly which data we need. We have a good connection to the German tax authority, and it's much easier to make right filings than having an audit.